outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Ho, 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 Merry Christmas, everyone, and welcome to this week's very special Christmas Celebration Assembly. I am Tyler Lewis, and my co-host is Jax Taylor. As an internationally minded school, we feel it is really important to understand the major cultural celebrations and share the joys of who celebrate. I'm saying this as there is a world map behind me.
Before we start, we would like to remind you about our personal goals during the assembly times. Please make sure you listen carefully throughout our assembly. This shows that you're being a respectful penguins. Before we start, we have a special message from a very special visitor.
Well, hello there, Nexus. Let me say, it is lovely to see you all. Feels like an awful long time since I was last there. I know it's only been a year, but it's certainly been an odd year, hasn't it? An unusual one. You all know all about that. Let me tell you, we have not escaped those changes at the North Pole either. Certainly not. It has proved quite difficult to find masks that are small enough to go on an elf's face. And when you do find them, the strings, then it turns out they're not long enough to go over the long pointy ears, and that's been all sorts of difficulties. I, obviously, have had a little difficulty finding masks that fit me. They need to be quite wide to cover all of this. And then the reindeer, well, they're refusing to correctly sanitize their antlers. So it's been all sorts of difficulties we've had. But enough of this talk. We all know the problems we've been going through. This is the time where I would normally be saying to you, have you been a good little boy? Have you been good boys and girls? Are you on the naughty list or the nice list? But I don't have to do that this year. This year, Miss Clare, hello Miss Clare. Miss Clare has written to me to tell me that all of you have been extremely good. That every one of you has done everything that you need to do to make certain that you keep yourself and your friends and your family safe. You've all worn your masks very comfortably, you've all washed your hands when you were supposed to, and you've all done everything you needed to do. And I must say, I should tell you now, that all of your teachers and all of us up here at the North Pole, we're all very, very proud of how well you've coped with what's been a very tricky year. Well, the year's almost at an end. Christmas break is coming up. And I hope everybody gets a chance to relax and to spend some time with their families and have a lovely time. If you're expecting to see me soon, well, you keep an eye out because I'll be on my way. And to everybody, Merry Christmas, and I hope a very happy new year.
Each year group has been learning about how Christmas is celebrated and listening to songs and stories. We are now going to share our learning. Sit back and enjoy.
Said the snowman.
No, no.
Hi everyone, would you like my hat? I made it and a little help from my mum. What do you call a reindeer with no manners? Rudolph. Bye!
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Donut.
Donut who?
Donut, open this present until Christmas. What do reindeers say before they tell you a joke? This one's gonna slay you. What do you call an old snowman? Water. What do you call a baby elf? Elfish. What does the gingerbread man put on his back? A cookie sheet.
Ho 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 ho.
Hello, Nexus. Today I'll be explaining my Christmas family traditions. So, my first tradition I'm going to be telling you about is the Advent calendar tradition. So, every day of December, from the 1st to the 24th, we open a little pouch or door in our calendar, like this one right here, and we get a little sweet to eat. The Christmas advent calendar is there so we can count the days down to Christmas Eve. And my mum made this one. I like it a lot. Hi again, Nexus. My next tradition is the tree tradition. I don't consider that a big Christmas tree right here. And so this is basically a tradition that everyone who celebrates Christmas does. And it is a special tradition because it's just very, very, you know, nice to have and stuff like that. Yeah, and we have baubles here, the heart there, and you can even make your own decorations like this one right here. And we collect decorations from all around the world where we go to put on our Christmas tree. Moving on. Our next tradition I am going to explain is our Christmas foods tradition. Just traditional foods that we eat around December, like these nice mince pies. On Christmas Day, it's traditional to eat a roast turkey. And after that, the most exciting thing of Christmas, the Christmas pudding. So the Christmas pudding is like a cake that you set alight with your matchsticks or a lighter. And after you've eaten that, sometime later you can, you know, eat some more mince pies, stuff like that. It's really, really fun Christmas foods. Okay, our next tradition is going back one day from Christmas Day to Christmas Eve. So, on Christmas Eve, we put out a mince pie and some milk for Santa and then carrots for the reindeer. Bye! Back again, I forgot one thing. We also put the stockings out for Santa to fill. So, stockings are like giant socks.
This is the Playmobil and the Quibber, Jesus. This is the stocking that Santa gives you every Christmas Eve. These are elf on the shelves. Go to Santa Claus and put it feel good. And this is the Rudolph statue. And that is a Christmas tree outside. And Christmas pillows. And we have, usually we have turkey for yummy food. Mince pies. And we have mince pies. And sometimes we use Santa some cookies and milk or mince pies. We also leave the reindeers some carrots. Thanks for watching!
We celebrate Christmas. In southern India, Christians often put small oil-burning clay lamps in the flat roofs of their house to show their neighbors that Jesus is the light of the world. Christians in Goa love to celebrate Christmas. Most Christians' families also have a nativity scene with clay figures in it.
The temperature in Australia on Christmas Day is usually between 70 to 85 degrees Fahrenheit. Since it is so hot, traditional Christmas dinners are replaced with family gatherings in backyards and picnics in parks and on the beach. Although it is so hot, some Australian people still have Christmas trees and lights, go carol singing, and send Christmas cards.
The Christmas feast in Denmark is celebrated at midnight on Christmas Eve. There's a special rice pudding dessert in which a single almond is hidden. Whoever finds the almond has good luck for a whole year.
Instead of Santa Claus, there's a bin of gifts named German Randy.
Children in France put their shoes by the fireplace instead of a stocking. Père Noël stands for Santa Claus, comes and fills their shoes with their prizes. They also have paper tunnels that goes bang when you pull it. I usually get some gifts during Christmas, but I don't celebrate Christmas.
In Germany, people celebrate Christmas by visiting their friends and family, putting Christmas decorations, and selling and buying things at Christmas markets.
According to legend, on Christmas Eve in Germany, rivers turn to wine, animals speak to each other, tree blossoms bear fruit, mountains open up to reveal precious gems, and church bells can be heard ringing in the bottom of the sea. Only the pure of heart can witness the Christmas magic. The Christmas tree was decorated on Christmas Eve and the presents are put underneath.
In England, it is a tradition to put a candle in the window of the home. It is a symbol to welcome strangers and remember those who are far away from home during Christmas.
Some homes are decorated with natural materials such as holly, pine cones, and ivy.
In Japan, instead of spending the holiday with their families, people spend their holiday doing nice things for others. Develop a plan to do nice things for other people. First, decide who you want to do something nice for. It could be people who are sick in the hospital, homeless people,
etc. On this day, Singaporeans eat berry pandan cake for dessert. For dinner, they eat satay turkey and nasi biryani something pink. They celebrate Christmas on the 25th of December and open presents on the 24th. One of the places that you can go to during Christmas are Orchard Road, Marina Bay, and Sentosa.
I celebrate Christmas in the UK and get presents and get stockings full of presents, and I can have sweets and chocolate and Christmas turkey.
Today's Christmas in the UK is similar to the United States. A traditional Christmas meal includes turkey. Christmas crackers are a tradition in the UK. Some families decorate their Christmas table with a cracker for each person.
From far up the chimney came down a ho ho. A little round man with a terrible scratching dropped into the room with a wink that was catching. Yes, down he came, bumping and thumping and jumping, and picking himself up without a sign of a bruise.
Ho, ho, what is this? Why they all are asleep?
But their stockings are up and my presents will keep. So in with the candies, the books and the toys.
all the goodies I have for the good girls and boys. I will run them and jump them and slam them and cram them.
All the stockings will hold while the tired Yorkster snores.
All the while his round shoulders kept ducking and ducking.
And his little fat fingers kept tucking and tucking.
Until every stocking falls out on the wall.
As if it were bursting and ready to fall.
By twisting himself like big in crystal.
And then all at once with a whistle and a whistle.
He bounced up again like a down of a thistle.
And nothing was left but a print of his shoe.
Wow, I really do feel very festive now. Thank you for everyone who is sharing the learning with us.
Now let's celebrate the birthdays of our learners who will have birthdays from Saturday 12th December up until we return to school after the holiday. Happy birthday to Yu Ern and Qumran in early years, Hisan in year 1, Sophie and Callista in year 2, Yasmin in year 3, Jingi in year 5, and Sophia, William, Jack, Stephanie and Iman in year 6.
We go to Miss Claire for her final message. Let's go to Ethan, who will be playing Happy Birthday. Please sing along in class.
Thank you so much to Tala and Jax for their fantastic presenting skills, and thank you so much to each class and all the teachers who have contributed to our special Christmas assembly. And thank you so much, Father Christmas, for taking the time in this challenging year to share a message with us. Now it's that time in the year, we've reached the end of term one, and sadly we need to say jumpa lagi, see you again, to some of our Nexus learners. But on a positive side, when we send our Nexus learners out into the world, out into the wider community, we are making the world a better place, because once a Nexus learner, always a Nexus learner. So you will be able to spread and use your personal goals and your international mindedness to make the world a better place, even just in a small way, in every little bit of kindness or resilience or respect that you show will make the world a better place. So we say jumpa lagi, see you all again. And to our friends who are moving to different countries, please do make sure you come and see me before the end of today, because we have our special map in the office, which I look at often, and our learners who go to different countries sign it so I can see where you all are, and hopefully you'll all come back and visit one day. So we say farewell to Daniel and Steve and Tasha and Mira and Farhan and Amira and Yitong and Yi Chi. Goodbye and good luck, and please do keep in touch. Keep using those personal goals, everybody. We also say a very special welcome to some new learners who will be joining us in January. And I know that you'll all make a big effort to to make them feel welcome when they do join us. And I'm mentioning this now because I will share this assembly with them. So we say welcome to Mustafa in year three, to Alia in year four, to Hani Safia in year five, to Amar in year six, and to Blessed in early years. And I know they're all very excited about joining us because I've had quite a nice chat with them all online. Okay, so I hope that you all have a very safe and restful and fun break. We look forward to seeing you all safe and well in January. But I'd really like to take this opportunity to say a massive thank you to all of our community. As we reach the end of the year and we approach the new year, it's a time to reflect, isn't it, on everything positive that's happened through the year, anything we would do differently, and to really take the time to think back. And I would just really like to thank our whole community. Learners, to you all, thank you. This year, you have been brave. You have been resilient. You have been positive and truly amazing in every single way. Everything that life's thrown at you this year, you've handled it with dignity and positivity. And that's amazing. In our global summit, which we will share with you soon, we're just finalizing the edits, we spoke to children from around the world, and it was really interesting, all of the similarities. What everybody said, whatever country they were from, they said that the challenges were they didn't get to see their friends or their family as much as they would like to. But their top tips that they wanted to share was to stay positive, to have hope. This is going to come to an end. We're going to get the vaccine. Things are going to move back to normal. So let's just keep going. I would really like to thank the parents. Thank you for your collaboration this year. Thank you for your support. This year has really emphasized more than at any other time the importance of collaboration, of working together and listening. And I think you've really helped us with your collaboration this year. So thank you so, so very much. And a very special thank you to our amazing teachers. You have had to adapt your whole approach this year to teaching at record speed and learn new skills whilst facing all of the challenges of the pandemic. And I know many of our teachers will be really missing their families this year, but they have continued, you have all continued to be so professional and so dedicated, and we are so very lucky to have you all. What a fantastic community. And I'm really looking forward to 2021 and all of the wonderful, exciting things that we have in store. So thank you so much, everybody. Have a wonderful break. For those who are celebrating Christmas, Merry Christmas to you all, and we'll see you safe and well in January. Take care.